How many of y'all are Christians and have an iPhone? How many of you folks are Christians and actually have an iPhone? If you got an iPhone, you're a Christian. If you don't have an iPhone, you're saved. You're just, you know, barely saved. You're kind of saved. You're almost saved. No, I'm kidding. So this has happened to every last one of you that drive. You drive and you're trying to get a location. Now think about this, man, 20, 30 years ago, where you had an address and that was that. Well, where is this at? Well, go this far, turn right here. Maybe you had a Mapsco where you could look on the map and had someone. But nowadays, what you have is Siri. Or whatever you have. What do they have for this blasphemous Android lover? What do they have? what's the Siri, the Android version of Siri? Does he or she have a name? Look at Catherine. Catherine says Team Android. what is her name? Do you all have Siri also? Whatever it is, you push in your direction, and she tells you where to go. Matter of fact, if you got your music playing in your car on your phone, hey Google, okay. If you have BlackBerry, wow. If you have Google or BlackBerry or Siri or whoever it is on your phone, it's telling you the directions. You might have your music playing through the car as well. And so while your music is playing, the lady steps in and says, stay in the right lane, turn right, and get off on exit 42A or what have you. And go this way and go that way. You all have that happen for you, right? I want you to understand that Siri is not saved. You need to understand that. Why do I say that? Because sometimes Siri tells you where to go and you miss your exit. You take a wrong turn. You go too far. You think it was 42, get off on 42A, but it was 42B. I want you to know that Siri is not saved. Siri does not have the Holy Spirit. Well, what do you mean, Corey? Well, because when you turn off on at the wrong place, what do you tend to do? You tend to either panic, get bothered, flustered, daggum, I done missed it. I've missed a turn. I've done this. And you might get a little frantic. You might, wait a minute, doggone, man. You might get bothered. But you know who doesn't get bothered? Siri. Siri doesn't get bothered. Again, Siri is not a Christian. That's it. Look, he said, what does she do? She just reroutes you. And I want you to listen the next time you take the wrong turn. Think about this, ladies and gentlemen. The next time you take the wrong turn, don't think about the fact that you took the wrong turn. Listen to the voice of Siri. And I want you to notice something. Siri's voice did not go up an octave, did not increase in volume or intensity, did not get bothered. Siri did not come back and say, doggone it, you missed a turn. Whatever are we going to do? They might even literally say rerouting, or they might just do it and just tell you, proceed forward and turn left, turn right. Guys, Siri is not a Christian. Siri's not safe. Siri does not have the Holy Spirit. The reason why I'm pointing this out is when this happens, and we all have been there, when we go on the wrong route, taking the wrong turn, how is it that Siri, as ungodly as he or she is, does not get bothered, all out of sorts, but you who have the Holy Spirit do? How do you get bothered when you have to be rerouted? Siri doesn't. Just reroute. Just fine. Take the next turn. Do this. Do that. You've taken plenty of missed turns in your life. You have been right. And by the way, as I'm saying this, Siri, this goofy Siri, is literally on my phone taking dictations of everything I just said. Siri's pretty obedient. Now, when I want her to do something right, she won't do it. But Siri is not saved. You are. Siri reroutes. You get frustrated. Siri does what a Christian's supposed to do. You get bothered. Siri is not saved. You are. Let me give you a passage. 1 Peter 5:6. Therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you at the proper time. Look what he says. Casting all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Be of sober spirit, be on alert, for your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion seeking someone to devour. Siri is not saved, but you are. Google is not saved, but you are. And for the two people that are using BlackBerry, not saved, but you are. What are you anxious for? This whole issue about mental health, God has always asked you to cast your cares on him. I don't know what your issue is. Everybody has something. Everybody has had trauma. Everybody has had stress. Yeah, somebody that's been in a war-torn place and they've seen their buddies get shot or blown up, that's not normal, but neither is rape. That's not normal. Nor sexual assault. That's not normal, but it happens. Being homeless, that's not normal, but it's happened, hadn't it? Being rejected by everyone, that's not normal. Going to prison, that's not normal, but it happens. My point is, there are a lot of different things that can cause stress, anxiety, trauma. You know what that is? Life. But do you know who we have above that life? God. That's why he says, let's put it back on the screen. That's why he says, cast your cares on him. He cares for you. What you think about that? The one who created all of this, who's got you. He cares for you. So he says, cast your cares on him. It should never be that you can find comfort and solace in anything else more than you can find in Christ. I want you to remember in those times, even if you missed your turn, or even if someone said the wrong thing to you, or you lost your job, or you didn't get the promotion, or he didn't propose to you, or she left you walking on you, or everyone has turned their back on you, or you don't have the money that you need, or the car breaks down, whatever, remember, neither Siri nor Google nor BlackBerry or anyone else, the pill, the counselor, they're not saved. The pill isn't saved. The textbook isn't saved. The computer isn't saved. You are. Think about that. What do you think God wants you to do? He wants you, because he said it in his book. I didn't write it. He wrote it through the power of the Holy Spirit. Cast your cares on him. The one thing that we should not see in this heated, and it's getting heated, in these conversations about mental health, are people arguing about concepts, about philosophies, about what's happening in the brain. I don't care what's happening in your brain. I don't care what's happening in your life. I care what the scriptures say, because the scriptures are what we should adopt and adapt ourselves to. So when he says, cast your cares on him, and you don't, and you are feeling stressed, you are feeling depressed, you are feeling weighed down, you are feeling heavy laden. I seem to recall someone who got on the cross says, come unto me, all ye, I'm King James Version for some of you folks, all ye who are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. And then you don't do it and then complain. Tell me, what sense does that make? You are heavy laden, you got anxieties, you don't cast the cares on him, but you're willing to talk to your friend. Girl, I'm feeling bad. Man, I'm not feeling today. I'm feeling depressed. Well, no wonder. You did not do it. He makes it so simple. He makes it, how simple does he make it? So simple an idiot like us can get it. We can just read it and go with it. He didn't. You don't have to know Hebrew or Greek to get that. You don't know have to know Hebrew or Greek to get that. Cast your cares on him. Come on. This is Jesus now. Come unto me, all you who are heavy laden. Let me carry the weight, because you've already demonstrated you can't do it. And we know you can't do it, because the next time you take the wrong turn at the wrong mile marker, you get frantic, bothered, even though Siri is just as calm as she was before. Do not refuse to cast your cares on him. Look to him. Go to him. This is what praying without ceasing looks like. I'm praying while I'm driving. I'm talking to him. The lines of communication have not been cut off. So when I have to reroute because my job is downsizing, when I have to reroute because I got to take another test, when I have to reroute because I now have 10 years left to live rather than the 30 or 40 that I thought I was going to live, when I have to reroute, when I have to reroute because we're getting divorced, when I have to reroute because the money isn't quite where it should be, Siri isn't upset. So my question is, why are you?